WNYWatercooler.com.
WNYWatercooler.com. You're a clown, Steve. I'm tired of the clown show. Tired of it. You've got a playoff team. You got a team that's won three in a row, and you're miserable because you love being miserable, because that's what you're about.
Yo, is there any chance you can pause this? Pretty sure Mallory's about to throw up everywhere. Hang on, I gotta get her out of the car and, like, or can we call back and continue? I don't know how this works.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, I gotta get her out of the car. She's, like, about to puke, I think. Hang on, I'll call you back.
Fuck you all! Fuck the fucking Patriots! I'll kill the shit!
Yes!
What are you doing, bro? Let's go, Bill!
Go, let's go! Go!
Welcome back, WNYWatercooler.com podcast, Spotify, iTunes, YouTube. We got Coast online. I'm Steve.
Janice, what's up, man? We got another playoff preview. Just normal times for us.
Yeah, I guess so. Is it four out of the last 5 years, or three out of the last four?
Four out of the last five.
Yeah, although, I mean, last year, well, that Colts game, like, the Colts game counts. I don't know, that Ravens game was kind of a weird one, but, and the Blackcoats against Houston, and we did lose to the Jacksonville Jaguars in the playoffs, and they tanked our season this year, just about.
Yeah, I mean, all true. I don't know what you're talking about last season, but, I mean, that Ravens win was one of the most electrifying games I've ever watched. The Colts game, nice win. Blackcoats game will haunt us forever, without a doubt. Oh my God, that was a brutal loss.
And, I mean, Houston, after that, was, like, dismantled. So it was kind of like...
Wait. So what happened again? So the guy catches the ball in the end zone and then just drops it?
Yeah, he picked it up and then threw it.
But he never, like, kneeled it or anything. And then we recovered it for a touchdown. And the ref calls it a touchdown. And then the refs from the sidelines, the black coats, come running on and say, well, he didn't mean, it wasn't his intention, right? Something like that.
Yeah, it was under review and there was black coat dudes on the field. And it was just like, we thought that it would at least be a safety, I think. Or maybe I did.
Maybe it was supposed to be a safety, yeah. But, I mean, the point being that they basically ruled that he just was meaning to give himself up, but he never really did. He just dropped the ball.
Yeah, they read his mind magically.
And regardless, what a joke.
We still choked in that game anyway. But although we came back, and then... choked again. It was a very weird game, but it was like an inflection point in these franchises.
Did you see Allen did the lateral, the knock lateral again?
Yeah, he did.
Unbelievable play. I was going nuts. It was so smart. He got the clock stop, which is exactly what happened against Houston. Exactly what happened.
Well, not exactly. No, he didn't throw to anyone in the Houston game.
Yeah, but it ended up like going out of bounds and it stopped the clock.
Jesus. Yeah, okay, that was a smart play. The Knox play, it was dangerous, though. He, like, gunned it at him. I don't know, maybe they were... the guy has no touch. He needs a little touch on that ball in the wind and cold, but maybe after four more years of this, he'll learn that.
I don't think you can... I mean, I don't know. We talked about it every week. The weather for these home games that you guys had with your has just been unprecedentedly terrible.
And the games themselves are boring as hell. Every game at halftime, it's just like, What did I watch? I'm gonna go take a nap. Like every
it all blends together. The shit weather with the shit opponent leads to a shit game.
Yeah, I walk into the tunnel at halftime and I'm just like, I'm always like in a daze. Like, what did I just watch? Did anything happen in the first half? Like, I mean, yeah, the Diggs touchdown, I guess, but even that was like, it was under review for a while. It's like, it was on the other side of the field. I couldn't really see it.
The review, yeah. And then we had another touchdown that was reviewed. Like, everything was reviewed for 5 minutes. Like, the Davis touchdown, Gabe Davis. Well, they ended up calling it not a touchdown, but that was one that was, I mean, it's like constant with the reviews. But, yeah, man, I can't even remember what the weather was like against the Jets. Cold, windy. The day before was snowing. This weekend, at least it's not going to be windy. It's going to be 0 degrees, though. So, good luck having on.
I'm sick of this whole media narrative of it's cold out. Wow, I can't believe it's going to be cold in the middle of January on a Saturday in Buffalo at 8 p.m. Shocker. A fucking shocker.
Well, I mean, the wind chill is going to be probably like -15.
What is wind chill? Explain it to me. You can't. No one can. They changed the wind. They changed the wind chill formula, too. Because they said,
I don't know what a formula is. I don't know how they come up with the actual number. It's I just know that when it's windy, it feels colder than the actual temperature. You can go outside, if it's 32 and windy, it's going to feel a lot different than if it's 32 and not windy. It's going to feel a lot colder.
Yeah, I know it's colder.
I don't know the formula. I don't know the formula, but if the actual temperature is zero, it's going to feel a lot colder than any wind.
They said 5 to 10 mile an hour winds, and it's going to be 10 degrees. And they said, but the wind chill is going to feel like it's 10 or 15 below. What is that? It's all made up. It's just it's made up. They said, oh, there was a game in 1994 against the Raiders game, the divisional round.
I was there. My rubber rain slicker froze in the seat.
Was it yellow?
Yellow froze in the seat.
Well, they said, oh, that was colder, but back then they calculated the wind chill differently. How does the wind chill calculations change in my lifetime? What world am I living in? I don't understand what world I'm living in. I haven't for a long time either.
I don't know, but that game was cold. It was really cold that day. I remember that.
Just like this dickhead for the Patriots, this D-tackle, is crying. He gets carted off, and now he's practicing or limited in practice. How does that work? I don't understand.
I don't know.
I mean, these Belichick fucking injury reports are meaningless. I mean, they put him out there, and I have to look at him on Twitter every day, and it's like, does this mean anything?
I don't think so. They got two corners that might not play, right? One's on their Bills on the COVID list. Is it Duggar, like, question? I don't know what's going on with him. So they got some issues there. But I'll wait and see what happens. I'll wait until I don't believe anything until Sunday morning or whenever we play. Saturday
at 8:15. Yeah, Sunday I'll call you right before the game starts. We'll talk.
Yeah, like Kendrick Bourne last time we played, and it was like COVID list all week, and then bam, he's good to go.
Yeah, I mean, the guy, also Belichick, overrated. What has this guy done lately? I mean, he decides to go with Mac Jones, McCorkle. This guy is supposed to be some savior. They lose to the Dolphins? They get swept by the Dolphins?
I think the Patriots are the team that is, they're not very talented, especially on offense, but they're, you know, they're well coached. They're going to beat the shit teams. They like to run up the score against the shit teams. But when they play teams that are good, I mean, we've seen what happened the last month. They lost to us, they lost to the Colts, they lost to Miami, and pretty convincingly so. And so, I don't know, we'll see what happens. I mean, I feel uncomfortably confident. So, all weekend, you know, I did not want to play them because it's just so annoying playing them. But now as time goes on and I think
Everyone's only talking about is the weather. So, they're like WGR dickheads are just trolling like through Boston media to find any story worth talking about. And they're probably not talking about anything because they know they're going to lose, but it's just weather, weather, weather. Oh, it's going to be windy. Oh, it's going to be cold. Oh, there might be some snow. Like, that's all that anyone's talking about.
It's not going to be windy, though. 5 to 10, it's not windy.
Yeah, I guarantee tomorrow I'll wake up and the forecast will change. It'll be, oh, it's 15. How is it going to be 35 on Sunday and on Friday? I don't understand that.
I think you're, I don't know why it's bothering you so much, but it's definitely going to be a factor.
I don't need another reason. It just bothers me. I hate weather talk. Weather talk to me, it's like, oh, Bullets Dome Stadium. They're not building a Dome Stadium, and if you want a Dome Stadium, fuck off. I don't understand it.
Well, I think it's just because of how this season has gone. There just hasn't been, all the way back to September, every game has been shit.
Well,
except maybe the Dolphins game. And it's been a story of the season. Like, we haven't been that good at home, or we haven't looked that good at home. We haven't, our stats, everything you look at hasn't been good at home because of every fucking game. It's snowing. It's not even the snow. It's just the wind and the rain and the everything. Every week it's something. And it,
then build a wind wall.
That's what you're going to get. That's what you're going to get here in January, though. And guess what? I think we're ready for it, man. I think we're going to run for 200 yards. I think that our
running the ball
is going to take us. I think we could. I think our running game. I really think our running game is going to take us all the way to LA, man. I really do. I think that Allen, Singletary, we're all in on this now. It's the playoffs. Allen's going to run on Saturday night.
Well, if you say so. I can we ever predict what Dayball's going to do? I mean, one week you love the guy, one week you want to fire him. I can never keep track. So you're back on the Dayball? Devin Singletary,
no,
all of a sudden,
not,
right?
I'm not back on the Dayball. I thought we were terrible for about half of the Jets game. And I don't want
then
to.
Then why are you confident now?
I think that we called against the Jets for the second. I looked it up earlier in the week. We had like 9 drives where we like punted 8 times or something like that. And I felt like that whole stretch we were just calling the same play over and over.
Hey, you kept talking about that on Twitter. What is it? Why would we have done anything like exotic or interesting on offense?
That's what I'm saying, though. That's why I'm trying not to like think too much into it.
Because you were thinking too much into it, I think.
It was like shotgun. Like, every play, shotgun, and, like, regular, like, nothing, we just did this, it just seemed like we were doing the same thing over and over. It's like it's how I felt against Jacksonville, where we just, it seemed like the same thing over and over and over. And in the fourth quarter, when we, like, were like, okay, we got to, like, actually win this game, is when we started to just do different things. And, you know, we were running with McKenzie, Allen was running more. It just seemed like we kicked it into gear.
Yeah, we're playing down to our opponent or playing up to our opponent. I mean, other than the Colts game, was there any game we really didn't look, we looked completely outmatched?
I mean, even the Colts game was fluky.
Yeah, it was ugly, though.
Well, they kicked our ass, but like we talked about last week or whatever, like the McKenzie fumble, I mean, it could have been a totally different game. And if there was ever a situation in that game where Wentz had to do anything, like, it could have just been way different. I wanted the Colts in the playoffs. I'm disappointed we couldn't get that. I wanted the Chargers.
Yeah, these teams that didn't even make it somehow. I mean, that Chargers game, I was too tired. I didn't watch the second half of it, but, I mean,
Oh, you were at the game, though. I watched that whole game.
Yeah. Shocker. But, well, just circling back real quick to this weather point. The teams that are in the playoffs, Bengals, Patriots, Bills, I mean, at least in the AFC, Kansas City, those are all cold weather. So four out of all the teams that are in the AFC in the playoffs right now, the only ones that are the Raiders playing a dome. And they'll probably get hit by it Cincy this week. But, I mean, there's just going to be cold weather games. We're not going to always have home and field advantage. Tennessee, it could be cold, too. So,
and I think I've done a 180 cold weather thing. I think we're built. I think we're ready to thrive in it. I really do. I think that now where we have to.
I'm living in a bizarre world.
No, dude. We talked about this. I don't know if it was which game it was, but the only way that we could make a run this year is if we just relied like threw everything on Allen's shoulders. Run to pass. You can't run Allen 10 to 15 times a game all season. You can't.
Well, yeah.
I feel like it's not sustainable. there's an injury risk, all that stuff. But now for a month, that's what we have to do. And he's like, his running is unbelievable.
Well, so, yeah, I mean, he's pretty much unstoppable if they pull the guard and they do the, like, naked, the bootleg.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not a naked bootleg, but the bootleg thing, whatever, they go around the tackle and pull the guard. It's like, he makes one guy miss, he's going to get 18 yards, it seems like.
Yeah, and the threat of the pass, too, on those plays, and, like, I think we could see, you know, another, you know, 60, 70 yards rushing, 200 yards pass, 200, 250 yards passing in these games, and that's how our offense is going to, and then, it's just how it seems to open it up for Singletary, too.
Well,
so, I mean, there's no action. I mean, there's. Singletary has looked his best the last month. I think there's a couple reasons for that. One, I think that Allen, like, that threat of him running helped, and I think that they're just playing Singletary, like, a ton. So he's able to get, like, a foot a game. It seems harder for running backs to, like, play well when it's, like, on for three plays off, not, like, splitting 50-50. Like, he's playing better now because he's getting 20. He's on the field the whole game, basically.
Well, yeah, I mean, if he's expecting to get most of the carries, I guess. I mean, like, Pollard for the Cowboys, he comes in and spells Zeke, and he's fine. But this game, the line, it's only four. I mean, maybe we're just too confident. But if this is just two generic teams, you had to you take away the names. This line doesn't make any sense. Patriots are, like, banged up. Their left tackle is probably not going to play. Their starting D-tackle was carted off last week. Everyone on our team, the Bills, is healthy. Our offensive line has been playing as well as they've done all season. We've gotten all these dudes back on the defensive line that didn't play against the Patriots. Like, Phillips is playing better, and they got Starr back. Like, I mean, other than Trey White being gone, I don't see how the Patriots win unless it's like Harris really just runs all over us and Joshy Poo goes Joshy Poo.
Joshy Poo, that needs to be made by 20. The way we lose is,
I mean, I can picture us losing, obviously, but
yeah, obviously,
just because it's Belichick, that's the only real reason.
Both games is the same thing. We turn it over, give them 3 points, that's how we lose. We had no turnovers in New England. I mean, our defense didn't play great in that game. They gave up 21 points, 3 touchdown drives, back-to-back long touchdown drives in the second half. We couldn't put the game away because we scored, they marched right down and scored. Then we would score, they'd march right down and score. Like, we kept going up double, like, past, then it would be cut, or whatever. You know, we were up double digits, and they would cut it to one score ahead. Like, we couldn't get a stop on D, but the way we lose is if we give them 3 points. I mean, we basically did.
Yeah, if we have 2 more turnovers than they do, and we have, like, special teams boners. But what was the Hawk or Hawk or punter? Was he so horrible that they're booing him and shit? Like, in the stadium,
he had like an 8-yard punt. Like, he literally, he had multiple shitty punts. Then he dropped a snap. but he was punting into the wind, so I think he was probably trying. Like, he wasn't trying to kick it like normal. This is what I heard. He was, you know, I don't know, they try and like kick it lower or do something different, but he kept fucking up.
Didn't we punt on 4th-and-1 twice too? Like, in the stadium, you can't. I don't keep track of punts because it's like I can't tell.
The 4th-down punt, I just can't take it. We punted we were at our old 39.
And how long was the punt?
But, like, why would you give, I don't remember if that might have been the punt. Like, the Jets touchdown, I think, was off a drive where they only had to go, like, 40 yards. Maybe that was the fumbled snap. I don't remember. But you're punting from your old 39, you're punting 100% of the time against tackle. I don't care what anyone says. There's, like, a 95% chance, literally, that you're going to get the ball right back. Why risk giving them the ball inside the 40? I don't care if it's 4th-and-1. You're playing Zach Wilson. There's no need to go for it.
But that's you could say that to the other. You could say that the opposite way. You're playing Zach Wilson. Give him. Who cares? I mean,
yeah, but you can. If they get one first down, they can kick a field goal. Wouldn't that they're back?
Yeah, I mean, I don't even know the exact scenarios.
Accidentally, you can get a first down on accident. analytics shit. Like, the fact that anyone was trying to defend Brandon Staley for it on, like, 4th and 3 from their own, like, 16, it's just fucking absurd.
Well, yeah, it's fourth.
Pardon my language.
For fuck's sake. It's 4th and 2 from their own 18, and they run the ball directly into the line. I mean, if you're going to go for it, you got to at least have a good play. You're not going to run your midget running back into, like, a very good defensive line. But, yeah, and then they're like, oh, they only gave him 3 points. Well, wasn't that the difference in the game? I mean.
Yeah, but those same assholes will be like, well, you can't, like, it wasn't a good decision because they only scored 3 points, but you can't look at it after, you know?
Yeah, they have it both ways too. If they look at the result,
the analytic assholes are saying, "Oh, it wasn't the middle." But guess what? You didn't have to go for it from your own 16-yard line. You gave them a free field goal in a game that went to overtime. So, Staley did this a lot this year, where he's just like giving up free points. The games they have, they lost the Chiefs in overtime, and he just like gave up for like 9 points in that game.
Well.
The
funny thing is, they're not in the playoffs, so I bet you he changes the way he is next year, and then they're probably going to be worse.
Though, he's going to just point to the map that, like, it's infallible.
Yeah, but with him, he wasn't, like, completely married to it. Did he, like, pick and choose? There's certain, like, he had a few, like, where he didn't go with the quote-unquote math, but I don't give a fuck about the Chargers. No one cares about the Chargers, literally. They don't have any fans.
I mean, it's just an interesting game to talk about because it really impacted us.
So we would have played the Chargers if it was a tie. Or
yes, we played the Chargers in a tie. Yeah, if it tied, we would have played the Chargers. They would have had to come cross country, play in 0-degree weather on a short week.
I would not have been scared of Justin Herbert and that
the
team.
Thing about Herbert too is everyone loves Herbert. Awesome. He made some amazing plays. But, dude, they converted, like, 5 or 6 4th and 10. And, yeah, some of the throws were, like, incredible throws. Like, but they also had 3 shit plays in a row before that. Every time. It was, like, 3 shit plays, amazing play. 3 shit plays, amazing play. Pretty lucky, in my opinion. So, like, I think people need to chill. Like, Herbert, incredible talent, incredible arm, makes some incredible plays. But they also, like, 75% of the plays sucked.
Well, yeah, I mean, I think, well, they probably would have talked about the weather even more with the Chargers coming to town. I mean, like, yeah, geez, it would have been worse. At least it's 2 cold-weather teams, although McCorkle, is he going to try and pass the ball more than 3 times this week? I imagine he'll have to.
I think it'll be single digits. I mean, if we get the lead, I don't even know. I mean, we'd have to be up, like, 2 TDs, I think, for them to start throwing. In the second half, I think it's going to be not as extreme as the first game, but similar. I just can't imagine McCorkle being able to throw successfully with, you know, his hand being frostbitten. I just can't see it.
How did they give up 33 points to the Dolphins? I mean, that seems like a miracle to me.
Wow, I mean, how good is their defense? They played. You know,
well just run.
That winning streak they had was against terrible teams.
Yeah, I'll go through it right now. They lost to the Dolphins by 1, then they beat the Jets. They lost to the Saints bad. They lost to Tampa close in that primetime game.
It was a monsoon.
Yeah. Then they beat Houston by 3. They lost to the Cowboys in overtime. They crushed the Jets. Beat the Chargers by 3. Beat up Panthers. Crush the Browns, crush the Falcons. Didn't Tennessee have, like, no one playing in that game? Like, A.J. Brown?
They didn't have Jones, Brown, or Henry in that game. And they ran it all over. They ran for a ton of yards. And the Patriots got lucky with fumbles.
McCork's had 3-10 passing. But, yeah, that game, it was kind of, there was a lot of turnovers. And, yeah, there's fumbles and stuff in the second half. But without A.J. Brown, I mean, that's not the Titans, so. Or Henry, but then they beat us in a hurricane, and then they lost to the Colts by 10. They lost us by 12, and they crushed the Jags, and then they lost by 9 to the Dolphins. So, I mean, what's their best win was against the Titans with nobody on the roster.
Yep.
I guess.
Yeah,
I mean,
exactly. Yeah, probably. Not counting our win, but I don't think you can count our win. That's a win against us. So.
I mean, if you have a pass, if you have a quarterback that throws three passes, that's not a good win. I mean,
they're a good coach. They're a good defense. They are gonna beat up bad teams because of just, you know, they're not gonna screw those games up generally, and that's gonna get you a 500-ish record, and they probably overachieved this year by a win or two, but like, I don't know. We probably at the beginning of the season had them as like a 9-8 team.
I think most people were talking about them maybe sneaking into a wild card, especially with all the money they spend in free agency. Although, I mean,
yeah.
Most of those dudes, I don't think have really done much. I mean, getting back some of the players that were out last year helped, I think, more than anything else. But yeah, they're 1-3 in their last four. We're 4-0 in our last four. I just this line to me, it's puzzling. I don't get it.
Well, there's definitely like a 3-point Patriots pass problem. Just because, you know, they're the Patriots and they were 7-point favorites last week in Miami. That's just not, I mean, ridiculous to me. They always struggle in Miami. Miami's won 7 of 8 games. They have a good defense. I can't believe that line was 7. That line should have been like 3.
Then how do you fire your coach after that too? I don't understand the Dolphins. That team is mystifying to me. They completely, I mean, McDermott eats their lunch every year, and they just, they're Dolphins. The Dolphins are just, they're a disgrace. I don't understand that franchise.
I actually think Flores is a good coach, but I think what's done him in is the whole quarterback situation. Last year was weird with the way the ownership clearly wants Tua to be the guy, I feel like.
But then the ownership also wanted Watson. So it seemed like they wanted two things.
Where are those Watson rumors coming from?
I think the owner actually said something, like, publicly. I mean, you can't technically say, I don't know. There was something that Ross was, like, definitely in favor of getting Watson, I think. But, yeah, last year, I ripped that decision, taking Tua out, putting Fitz in, and, like, some people were defending the decision. Like, it made no sense to. You take him out and then you put him back in, and it was strange.
Yeah, just keep him out or keep him in.
Yeah.
They would play him and, like, they would play him and they'd be terrible. They put Fitzpatrick in, they'd, like, come back and they'd look good, and then the next week they'd just put Tua back in. They never should have put Tua in the first place. So I just feel like that has to be the reason why they let him go. There has to be some disagreement or power struggle between what he wants to do and what the ownership wants to do, probably with that quarterback.
Yeah, I'm guessing he must not get along with the GM, but I don't know. I mean, the Dolphins, they're gonna be like the Jets.
That's a back. Which is huge for us.
Yeah, I mean, what they're gonna draft, and they're gonna, I mean, unless they get Watson, but I don't know who they're gonna. It's still wasted a bunch of draft picks. I mean, they got Waddle, but the rest of the guys they took the last 2 years when they were chock full of these guys. I don't know. So yeah, last
week. I don't know either.
Yeah, McCorks last week, 20 of 30, 261, a TUD, an INT, had 2 sacks.
Yeah, but it was like garbage time.
Yeah, exactly. He was they're down the whole game, and he didn't even have a good statistical game.
They were down big, and then they scored 2 touchdowns in the fourth quarter or whatever, but it was like garbage time, I think, again. I mean, against us, he was terrible, but they probably, I don't remember. Garbage time stats against us, but I don't know. McCorkle's going to struggle in this game. I don't think they're going to ask him to do much of anything. I would be stunned. I wonder what his over-under for pass attempts is. It's gotta be, I bet you it's like 20 and a half. I'd be stunned if he threw more, unless we just run him out of the building. But
I wouldn't be shocked to see another quarterback playing in this game. I mean, I doubt they'll do that, but who, their backups are kind of.
Hoyer?
Yeah, it's Hoyer and Stedham, I think. I don't know.
Yeah. But Jones, you know, for karmic purposes, I don't want to rip him too bad. I mean, he's had a good rookie season, but I just don't think his ceiling is that high. Especially if he Mac Jones can't win the Patriots a game.
I mean, he could win them one. Can he do it in the cold on the road? No, not with the offense they have. I mean, he did have a pretty good year. He played better than I thought, but I mean, the way that they talked about him in November, like these analysts getting the vapors, like they're gonna pass out on their fainting couch over this guy like beating up on these shitty teams. It was just so overhyped. That's the annoying part about it. Like I mean, you can almost feel bad for the guy. I mean, obviously I don't, but it's just the hype around him was just like, what am I watching? What am I hearing? It made no sense.
Yeah, he was overhyped, and that was so annoying. You're right. It's not even like anything he did, but just all the general thing with the Patriots. Like if the Patriots beat us, even if it's totally lucky, fluky win, if you're like, oh, Belichick, you know, the way he coaches special teams, and they don't leave a stone unturned, and like it's just, it's gonna be just nauseating. That's why I didn't want to play them. So if we lose to the Patriots, I'm not gonna be able to watch the rest of the playoffs. So that's kind of.
Well, yeah, I mean, if the Bills lose this game, it's just like, okay, well, we won the division, and that's meaningless, but...
And no, I think winning the division is huge.
Well, not if they lose. I mean, if we lose this week, well, what was the difference? It was a home game instead of a road game at the Patriots. I mean...
I think that losing a wild card game takes away from them winning the division. I mean, it's just... obviously, I don't want them to lose. Like, I wouldn't... A wild card loss the season would be disappointing, so I will say that. But I don't think it means the division championship meaningless.
Well, it definitely takes a dent in it. I mean, the season is a failure if we lose, if we don't get out of the wild card round. I don't care if it's Bill Belichick.
Well, the opponent doesn't matter anymore to me. Like, I don't care that the Patriots are in a division. It's just the playoff game. It's just the whole playoff game. They got it. Favored, it's just, they gotta win.
It's you're saying it's a failure if they lose, correct? The season?
I'm saying the season is a disappointment.
Yeah, okay.
I'm still happy that they won the division, and I still think we're gonna be good for years to come. I think this year has been weird. I think that it's just been a strange season, so like nothing would surprise me at this point. So, I mean, gosh, I mean, who friggin' knows? Watch Cincy make a run. Like, it's just been that kind of year.
Yeah, I mean, the Titans having the one seed, and no one is talking about the Titans being, like, a Super Bowl contender, even. Which, I never understand this backlash that the Titans get. I never understand it. They have a couple bad losses. They didn't cover last week, but, like, take away your best offensive weapon, regardless of the position. I don't care what position it is. You take him out of the game, out of the season, and you take some of these receivers out. I mean, they've beaten all the good teams. They've beaten every good team in the AFC, haven't they?
They beat New England, they beat Austin, they beat Kansas City. They swept the Colts, I think. I think you're right. But they're just not that, like, their stats aren't that good. Their point differential's not good. But they play close games, and I don't know if it's like Walker skill, but they win them. We don't win them, so I don't know what it boils down to. But they've just gotten luckier this season. I guess all you can really say, they've just gotten luckier. I mean, Carson went through an interception in the end zone in that one game against them. They should have lost. Like
17 slipped on his toenail or whatever. So. Yeah, I mean, there's a few things that they benefit from,
yeah. Yeah, they've gotten lucky this season. I don't know what the record is in one score games, but they just seem to win them. And that's why they're the one seed. But they're not, they're only one seed. So it's like, it's a year where the Bills can definitely make a run, like go all the way. But it's also like, who would be shocked if it was just any team in the conference outside of, you know, the Raiders and Steelers?
Yeah, but then again, it's probably going to be the Chiefs and the Rams or Bucks again. I mean,
the Chiefs, people are still high on the Chiefs. They just lost to Cincy and then almost should have lost to Denver. Like, they would have lost to Drew Lock in a game with the one seed on the line if there wasn't a fumble touchdown in the fourth quarter. Like, 80-yard fumble touchdown return. So, I'm not scared of the Chiefs. different than any of the other teams outside of those bottom two. Like, it's their games. The games are probably going to be close. And I just think we have the upside to, like, blow teams out. I don't think that New England or Cincinnati, I don't think the other teams in the conference are, like, going to blow anybody out. But I think we have that upside. And I don't think the other teams do, including the Chiefs, unless they're playing Vegas. I mean, they're getting a gift. Just to be, that's the thing. They're getting a gift round one.
Yeah, I mean, you're playing against a team that, like, did anyone even think they'd be there? I'm looking for prop bets. So this website, I don't know what this website is, Eat, Watch, Bet, but the line, it's for Mac Jones passing yards is 209.5. They're saying take the over. There's Devin Singletary, 59.5 rushing yards. They're saying take the under.
So is this a Boston website?
I thought so, but I don't know. Then they're saying Jacoby Myers, 40.5 yards. They're saying take the over. This must be written by a Patriots fan or something. But then they have Cole Beasley over 33.5 yards receiving. And then the best bet was Damian Harris touchdown, anytime TD. So this is a funny.
Oh, that I can see. I can buy that.
Yeah. But, like, McCorkle's passing yards, 209.5. That seems high. I mean, unless you think that the Bills are going to roll him and they're going to have to pass the ball. Why would he have such a high number unless they're going to lose?
If the Bills are – the only way that I think that happens is the Bills are just killing them.
Yeah, exactly. I don't see any possible way he would throw that much.
No. Is there a pass attempt or completion, anything or no?
I'm trying to look for some of this other stuff.
I'm trying to look right now, too. Let's see.
I guess if I did any homework for this podcast, I'd have this already.
Yeah, so 202 on DraftKings, 202.5. The under is minus 130. The under 1.5 keys is minus 230. In completion, the over-under for completion is 19.5. And the under is minus 195. Pass attempts is 30.5. I'm going to pay that. But there's the risk of us killing them, which kind of is why I'm kind of hesitant to. If it's going to be a close game, there's no way in hell he's throwing 30 passes.
Well, what's the juice on the under 30.5?
Minus 135.
That's not even that bad.
So I think that builds in. I think that is taking into consideration that there's potential that there's a blowout.
Yeah, your best bet's like a same game parlay. Taking the Bills and then batting some of these Mac Jones things. I mean, you probably have sick odds on that. I mean, there's no other way that he gets some of those high numbers unless they're losing, like, bad. Even if they're down 10, I don't think they're going to let Billy Boy is going to, like, just unleash McCorkle on us. I mean.
Yeah, no. I don't think, unless we're off, like, at least 2 TDs, I don't think that they're going to start throwing a lot at all.
And I think, I mean, it sounds like I'm way too upbeat and positive about this, but even the defensive line, like, our defense is playing really well, our front seven. I mean, yeah, we played the Jets, I guess, but still, I mean, we're just, we're getting pressure from in the interior. Like, I mean, Eddie Oliver, who I've hated this guy.
He's been amazing.
Yeah, he's been really good, which, you know, fine. I'll eat some crow on that if he makes a play in this game. Hopefully he will, but I mean, what the whole thing was, like, D tackles, it takes years and years for them to actually do something, and then the Vikings will probably pay him a bunch of money. That's what always happens with our good D tackles, but.
The Bills minus 17 plus 350.
Don't waste your money. Why would you bet that, an adjusted line that high? I need more than plus 350.
Minus 18.5 plus 475.
You just said we're going to run the ball all game.
You can't even bet on the Patriots more than minus 8.
Yeah, I see this line. Well, it's solid.
Minus 8. Yeah, go ahead. Sorry.
It's minus 4. I think it'll be minus 5 at kickoff, or maybe even higher. Right. I think money's going to come in on the Bills. I just don't. see why people would put money on Bill Belichick and McCorkle when they haven't shown that they can do anything together. I mean, other than against a shitty team.
Yeah, I don't know. I was going to say, Pat's 9-8, Justin Line is plus 500. But our -8 adjusted line is only plus 145. Like, that's almost, it's just weird that this line is only 4. I just don't understand.
Yeah. Well, we actually agree. Shocker.
Yeah. I mean, it should be, what should it be, 7?
I would say it should be 6 or 6.5. I mean, 7, they don't like to put a 7 line unless they, but yeah, they want to keep it off teasers and stuff, but it's going to be cold, allegedly, so I'll wear an extra fucking pair of pants and I'll be perfectly fine. Although, I don't know, they're hyping Joshy Food complaining that it's cold. I don't know. He said that he has bad circulation in his blood? The fuck?
Well, we better have a good heating crew, like with the coat and the hand warmers. And the
get a fluffer out there for him.
They got to be on their game.
Get some porn screens out there to keep the blood flowing for him. Jesus.
That line is -3. But the full game line is -4. Explain that to me.
That's not usually how gambling goes. I can't figure it out. It's just
-3 is -115 too.
It's like there's a Patriots tax. It's because last time the Patriots were in the playoffs, weren't they getting smoked by the Titans at home? I mean,
they lost the Titans at home.
I don't know. I mean, I'm not gonna say it's gonna be a blowout. I'm just partly because of the cold and I don't. There's something fluky is going to happen. I know something bad and fluky is going to happen to keep this game close. The refs and the NFL do not want this to be a blowout. They want to keep Patriots and Mac Jones and Belichick alive as long as possible. I know it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm 100% on board with the NFL. You know, I'm not a big conspiracy theory guy, but when it comes to NFL refs and penalties, nothing would be unbelievable to me.
Is black coats one word or two? I mean, that's all I gotta say. Black coats.
Yeah, I think there's a dash, a hyphen.
Yeah. Well, what's your prediction for this game? Unless you got any other takes.
No. I mean, I think that you're gonna struggle to score. I think that the cold weather is gonna make it. No, I don't see them being able to move the ball. I think our defense will do good enough against the run. I mean, I think Harris will have some good run, but I don't expect us to get. I mean, all we can do is not give up any, 50 yards, because they're not going to run it down the entire field. So I think we can hold them under, under 17 points. And offensively, like I said before, I think Allen running. And single, I think our running game, I think we're going to run for 200 yards. And I think we're just going to smother them and dominate, just basically dominate the line of scrimmage.
Just get the ball to Diggs. They need to get the ball to Diggs. You're running. All right, finish up here.
No, I mean, Allen, most of the running success, I think Allen is going to be able to run very successfully. And that's, the big thing for me. So I think we can beat them 26-3, honestly. But it's a playoff game, it's playoffs, close game. I don't think it'll be like that. I'm thinking my heart says 26-3, my brain says it's gonna be 23-16.
I was gonna say 24-16. I just think that Diggs, if we get the ball to Diggs, the guy right now is just on another plane, and Jackson. He owns Jackson, and the other corner's probably out, although who the fuck knows, maybe I can never trust Belichick with any of that shit. I'm not picturing this rookie bitch coming in here and winning in 12-degree weather. I just don't see it happening, unless fluky shit happens. They're not going to just beat us head-to-head. I don't think it's going to happen.
I agree with you there. If fluky shit happens, then all bets are off. I mean, they get a special teams TD bunch of turnovers, then obviously.
Hopefully we're not booing Hawk or doing the Bronx cheer for him when he gets a 35-yard punt off.
5 to 10 mile an hour wind is nothing, man. The wind in that game Sunday was Bash had a kickoff landing like the 20 into the wind.
Oh, yeah, I never said, like, after the game, I stayed actually till the very end. Me and Santa were going to, we were just waiting for the crowd to all run onto the field, and it just never happened. There's all these security people around. We're, like, ready. We could have jetted down there real quick. One or two people ran on. They cuffed a guy right away to, like, make it a point to say, hey, don't fucking do this. They took the goalpost down, I swear, before the game was even over in our end zone, because they could see people, like, going down there to do it, and we just didn't have the herd mentality to all jump over the wall at the same time. I was pissed, but I
didn't like. Good luck, good luck keeping the fans off the field on Thursday as well.
15.
So the AFC Championship game is going to be on when the 30th. 30th. Yeah. Good luck keeping the fans off the field after we punch our ticket to LA at home.
But it was cool being there. You know, Joshy Poo and Hyde were running around the whole stadium, high-fiving everybody. And
did you get down there close to the field at all?
No, we didn't bother. I would have went down there if there was a chance we were going to get on the field, but I wasn't going to go down there and stand. I wanted to just get out of there. It's not cold in the stadium, but, yeah, standing outside in the parking lot for 4.5 hours with the wind just blasting my face off my face is just like the wind. The temperature doesn't bother me. It's just the wind blasting through your body. It's just
the temperature doesn't bother me either. But when it's 4:30, I mean, Sunday it was like 25 mile an hour wind, not like 50 like the past game. But that's miserable, man. Like I said, the bass kicking into the wind, ball playing at the 20, hawk hit, the punts were. It was crazy. It was kind of crazy.
Par for the course this year. We'll see you around 3 at the parking lot then. I'm bringing a TV.
Bills like Buffalo, I'm all about the bills like Thurman Thomas. I don't tip, I pay bills. Bitches call me Buffalo.
If I could save time in a bottle.
Alright, go walk your dog.
I'm going
to
playoffs.
You kidding me? You kidding me?
Playoffs.
Don't talk about it. Playoffs. You kidding me? Playoffs. I just hope we can win a game. Another game.